Let's start off with this. Measure the length of this line. Well, you've got several choices. You could measure it in centimeters. You could measure it in millimeters. You could get yourself an old wooden ruler and measure it in inches. So there are several ways you could measure the length of a line, and several different units that you could use to measure a line. An angle. What about measuring this angle? We could measure this angle in degrees. But we can also measure an angle in radians. And that's what we're going to be looking at. Radians is another way of measuring an angle. So let's start with looking at the connection between radians and degrees. And the way we do that is to consider one revolution. If we rotated this one complete revolution, that would be 360 degrees. Or 2 pi radians. In other words, 360 degrees is equal to 2 pi radians. Now, if we used a calculator to work out what 2 multiplied by pi was, we get a decimal, which in fact can't be worked out. So one could argue that it's not as exact as measuring degrees, but I can assure you working with radians can be useful. So let's have a look at comparisons. Express the following in radians. So the only thing we actually need to remember is that 360 degrees equals 2 pi radians. Don't just put an R, that looks like radius. It's not the same thing. 360 degrees is 2 pi radians. Therefore, 180 degrees must be 1 pi radians. What about 60 degrees? Well, that's a third of 180 degrees. So that's pi over 3, or a third pi radians. About 45 degrees. Well, 45 degrees, a half of 180 is 90, so a quarter of 180 is 45. So 45 degrees is pi over 4, or if you prefer, a quarter pi radians. 90 degrees, as I've just said, is half of 180, so it's a half of pi radians. 270 degrees will be 390s, so we can write that as that many radians. But the only thing I need to remember is this one. All of the rest we can work out from that if we need to. We can also do the conversion round the other way. Express the following in radians. So what we need to remember is that 360 degrees is 2 pi radians. If I divide both sides of this by 360, I would find out that 1 degree equals 2 pi over 360 radians. Therefore, by using this piece of information and manipulating like that, I can work at any number of degrees. So 72 degrees would be 72 multiplied by radians. Now if we use the calculator, 72 multiplied by 2 multiplied by pi divided by 360, we'd find out that 72 degrees is 1.2 2566371, etc. radians. So to two decimal places. And if we want to know this 164, then we'd work out 164 multiplied by with the calculator. And converting radians to degrees. Well, all we need to know is that this many degrees is this many radians. All round the other way, this many radians is this many degrees. So if we divide both sides by 2 pi, we find out what 1 radian is. Therefore, we can work out any number of radians. So pi over 3 radians would be 2 threes are 6, 6 into 360 goes 60 degrees. So similarly, I could work out how many degrees there. Now we find why it's important that we should always use a degree sign if it is degrees. Let's move on to finding the length of an arc using radians. Now in fact this is so simple as to be rather unbelievable. And it's easily forgotten because it's so simple. Finding the length of an arc using radians. And this is all you've got to learn. Length of an arc using radians is this formula, where r is the radius of the circle and theta is the size of the angle as long as it's measured in radians. So the length of this arc, PQ, is the radius of the circle multiplied by the angle measured in radians. 7.4 multiplied by 2.1. I often feel that it's such a simple formula, people just don't believe that it's as simple as that. But it really is. Should we choose to use radians or should we choose to use degrees? Well, in the middle of the exam, it's going to be up to you. But I generally say if it's question is in degrees, then work it in degrees. If the question is in radians, work it in radians. However, this might be just part of the question, and working in radians all the time might be the easier option. But anyway, let's have a look at this. Let's work it in degrees first. So the angle has been measured as 110 degrees. The complete circumference of a circle is pi times diameter. Circumference equals pi times diameter when we're working in degrees. So this is a fraction of the whole circle. It's 110 360th of the whole circle. So the length of this arc PQ is going to be 110 over 360 multiplied by pi multiplied by the diameter of the circle, appreciating that the diameter is twice the radius. 110 divided by 360 multiplied by pi multiplied by 2 multiplied by 5.8. And that will give you this answer. So the question is in degrees, so we've worked it out in degrees. But you could say, I'll convert it to radians, and I'll use the length of the arc formula using radians. All I need to remember is this connection that 360 degrees equals 2 pi radians. By the way, can I just go back to something? If we're going to be working with degrees and radians, we really must remember to put in the degree sign when it's degrees. Must, ought to do that. 360 degrees is 2 pi radians. Divide this side by 360, divide this side by 360, you find that 1 degree equals 2 times pi over 360 radians. Therefore, 110 degrees is going to be 110 multiplied by radians. So that will convert the 110 degrees into radians. 110 multiplied by 2 multiplied by pi divided by 360 radians. So that equals 1.919 etc etc. I'll just put dot 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 radians. So, length of an arc when we're working in radians is just r times theta. So the length of this arc PQ is going to be the radius of the circle multiplied by the angle measured in radians, which we've got here, etc. Now, I've actually got the full value of that still on my calculator, so if I choose to answer multiplied by 5.8, I will be working that out. And yes, as one would expect, it is exactly the same answer. So there we have it. Should we work in radians or degrees? Well, I generally say if the question is in degrees, do it in degrees. If the question is in radians, do it in radians. But for this level of mathematics, we really ought to be working in radians. So we can convert to radians and then we'll work in radians. Let's look at the area of a sector. And the same thing applies. The area of a sector is thought to be sometimes maybe too simple. Not quite as simple a formula as the length of an arc, but that is the formula for the area of a circle if the angle is measured in radians. So the area of this particular sector, which we call PQR, the area of this sector in here, shall we shade it, the area of this sector, area of sector PQR is going to be a half multiplied by the radius, R stands for radius, squared multiplied by the angle measured in radians. So if we say that this angle is 2.1 radians, then that will work out the area of this sector. 0.5 multiplied by 3.9 squared multiplied by 2.1 equals. And of course that is going to be square centimetres. I suppose you could say we could write that as 0.5 r squared theta, but it's usually written as a half r squared theta. The area of a sector, working in radians, is a half r squared theta. Same little question. If we're finding the area of a sector, should we use radians or degrees? Well, I'd use the same argument. If it's in degrees, then I'd actually work in degrees. The area of a circle, when working in degrees, is pi r squared. So 110 degrees, if this angle here is 110 degrees, we're talking about a fraction of the whole circle. We're talking about 110 degrees multiplied by pi r squared. So this will work out the area of this sector. Divided by 360 multiplied by pi multiplied by 8.5 squared equals. Square centimetres. But if we did this in radians, the first thing we'd have to do is to convert 110 degrees into radians. So let's do that, even though we've done it before, just to make it something a process that we're happy with, we need to remember that 360 degrees is 2 pi radians. Divide both sides by 360. When you first do these things, it doesn't matter how many times you practice the same thing to try and make sure it actually flows and you're happy. So we've got the 1 degree is that many radians. So my 110 degrees will be 110 multiplied by this. So let's do that on the calculator. 110 multiplied by 2 multiplied by pi divided by 360, 1.919 etc. radians. So the area of our sector PQR, area sector PQR equals a half r squared theta. So it's a half multiplied by the radius squared multiplied by theta measured in radians. So we've still got this in the calculator, so let's work that way and do answer multiplied by 8.5 squared multiplied by half or 0.5, and hopefully, and we do get exactly the same answer. It's not a difficult topic, this one, I don't think, but something else to try and learn and remember. Don't forget the units, square centimeters.